bend. You bend. If you can't touch your toes, it's okay. If you can, you can touch. But at least I want you to bend. Can we do that? Let's bend. I, some of you are not bending, unless you're holding a baby. I want you to bend. Obeying is good. Now some of you are wondering where. Now I'm not saying be stand up, and I'm not yet saying imagine. Now can we stand up? You can have a seat. And I'll tell you why I asked you to bend. They say experience is the best teacher. So sometimes it's good to have some experiences. Can you project for us Luke chapter 13, chapter 10, and verse 13? Luke 10, verse 13, New Living Translation. We are going to read together 13 to 17. Luke. Amen. It's coming. If revelation has come, it must pass. It must have passed through Luke. Amen. It is about to come. Keep on hoping. Sometimes you may have to wait longer. So you had better not give up. Luke 13, verse 10. Imekuja. Ama bado. Hapa ni kwa maoni. Amen. It has come. Can we read together? We are going to read verse 13 to 17. Yes, that's what where I want us to read. Luke 13, verse 10 to 17. Oh, I see.
Bent double. And as if that is not enough, he was
because she was bent double for how many years? 18 years. And I want to allow you to imagine how her day used to be like. Every day, 18 years, bent double. Somebody who is bent double, it's like you are shut from the rest of the world. The best you can see is people's shoes and the dirt on the floor. It is not possible for you to see how people are smiling, how they are laughing, how they are talking, because you can't see their mouths. You are bent double. It was a pathetic case. Verse 11. This lady happened to be where Jesus was. Irrespective of her condition, she purposed one thing. I may not know, I may not understand, I may not be invited for an interview, I may not go to the shopper, I may not be able to do many things. But no matter whether I'll go growing or I'll go walking or I'll go how, but I'll find my way to where Jesus is. Amen. Let me tell you, brethren, sometimes you have to defy the circumstances surrounding you and just decide, this is my condition, but I will be where I know at least somebody appreciates me. Amen. And I want you to imagine, I don't know how long she used to take to walk. It was not the time of Uber or Taxify or Dubify. It was a time where the best maybe mode of transport was riding on a donkey. And here this lady is bent double. So the only means of doing it was walking. And I can assure you, she was not walking at a speed. And maybe she just came late. Maybe she was the last one to arrive at the church. And remember, we are talking about that culture where a woman was second class. So I imagine she came late, and maybe there was a seat. They had the ushers of then had were used to give her a seat at the back with good intentions, maybe, so that it would be easier for her to get out. Nevertheless, she was where Jesus was. Praise God, because that day something spectacular happened. This lady is not the one who went to Jesus. It is Jesus who noticed her. And that's why I want us to read. Verse 12 says, when Jesus saw her, he called her over. Dear woman, you are healed of your sickness. I am imagining how she must have felt that day. Maybe that was the first time in many years anybody has ever, whether by mistake or intentionally, called her dear. And this time, Jesus was teaching. Jesus interrupted the sermon and called the woman over. And I'm imagining the leader of the service was getting impatient and wondering, what is Jesus exactly doing? I want you to imagine, I told you, she didn't have speed, but she had faith. This morning I want to talk to men and women listening to me, that you may not have everything that you need, but when you have faith in God, He finds a way to perform a miracle for you today. This woman, no matter how, she found herself in church, bent double, record by the world. We don't know of her name. Maybe they used to say, you can imagine, your guess is as good as mine. They had labeled her. You see their appearance, bent over, crippled, you know, whatever. I don't know what this morning they have labeled you. I don't know what they are saying. That lady, that girl, you see the circumstances which were beyond you. The Bible says that it was an evil was, there was a big crowd. So I want you to imagine, Jesus had to wait for her to come over. And after the deliverance, this is what Jesus did. Then he touched her. And instantly she would start straight. How I pray that this morning, you will find your focus one more time this morning, because Jesus is addressing your need. You will find your focus and know you don't have to be bent over. Somebody is thinking good about you. Jesus is in the house this morning to touch somebody. Verse 14. But the leader in charge of the synagogue was indignant that Jesus had healed her on the Sabbath day. Can I surprise you? Did you know, some of you may feel to come to church, what do you people say? Let me tell you, it is not everybody who is interested in your well-being. Some of them, they like it that way. Because you can come over and ask for help. You know some of us like, which is here to those, you know, which is here to come on as a fan like you do. This reminds me of a friend of mine who took her car for a car wash. And while she was waiting for the car to be done, she saw a beggar. You know, you can tell people, these people who go begging, yeah? She saw the beggar coming to ask for help. Now, this is the friend. Now, this is the friend who was giving the testimony. And you know that. You know, you want to assume them. Those people, because you know they are coming to ask for, you close the windows. So this friend of mine, when she saw the man, she tried to avoid eye contact. And then finally, this man was so determined. He came closer and closer and closer. And finally, she could not avoid him. So in fact, she didn't wait for the person to ask for the arms. And this was the question. It seems like you want something. She's the one who asked, the one who was borrowing. And this man answered, yes, who doesn't? In my mother tongue, it goes something like this. Millicent, mensamehe in advance. Pastor Kaudo mensamehe, I'll translate. And then, yeah, but just allow me, for the sake of those who can get it in my mother tongue, to repeat what she said. You look like you want something. And this was the answer of the man who was begging. This one, who wouldn't want something? This was a wake-up call to my friend. Let me tell you this morning. You may look down on yourself thinking you're the only one in need. Let me surprise you and shock you. Every person who has entered through this door is because they are actually looking for something. So you better not miss out, because you look like you are so needed. If they were not needed, they would not be here. By the way, this is a place for beggars. We have all come to look for life. Amen. Only that we need different things. But we all need something. And I want to congratulate you. Congratulate your neighbor that they came to the house of God. Because they are needed. Tell them, I know you are here because you want something. Was in the house. I don't know what exactly, because in this scenario, Jesus is used to healing many people. In the book of John chapter 5, we find this man who used to report, and he would say that every time I want to enter, somebody else, when the angel has stirred the waters, somebody enters before me. But in his case, Jesus asked him what he wanted. But in this case we have just read, Jesus never asked her. This morning, Jesus knows what you need. Amen. This morning, Jesus wants to meet your need. This morning, do not empower your neighbor to prevent you from receiving your miracle. In any case, she also needs something. Actually, that's why she's seated. She should have gone home or gone home. He should have gone home. But you are here because you need something. This lady, the Lord noticed. Things happen. indignant. This is what the Bible says. Maybe you can take us to verse 15. But the Lord replied, "You hypocrites, each of you works on the Sabbath day. Don't you untie your ox or your donkey from its stall on the Sabbath and lead it out for water?" Verse 16. This dear woman, a daughter of Abraham, has been held bondage by Satan for 18 years. Is it yet like that she be released even on the Sabbath day? Jesus took over her battles. Let me tell you, when you're in the right place, the battle no longer belongs to you. The Lord takes over. Now it was Jesus versus the leader. And praise God, the lady was just praising God. Because of one thing that the Lord has taken over, that which was your battle. The Bible says in Proverbs 16, I think at verse 7, that when your ways please the Lord, He makes even your enemies to be at peace with you. This morning, your sole business should be to praise God, to worship God, to thank God. Because when you please God, He takes care of your enemies. May the Lord take over your battles this morning. May the Lord address your enemies this morning. May the Lord send your enemies to fright this morning, because you are in the right place. Verse 16 again. This dear woman, a daughter of Abraham. You are a son of Abraham. You are a daughter of Abraham. Maybe they have not given you a name. They pretend they have forgotten your name every day. A friend of, we went for a wedding not long ago, a few weeks ago, and I met a friend of mine. And then we saw another couple walk in. Then she told me, "See, I've told this lady many times my name. Do you know she never remembers my name, and we go to the same church?" Now she also happens to be my friend. Now the one who was being accused of forgetting your name. I pray you not be accused that you always forget somebody's name. That every day you nakutana unaniuliza, na unaitwaje? By the way, people get offended. Hata kadhalika basi usiulize. Kama umesahau, usimulize rafiki yako. Uliza mtu mwingine anakaa kama anajuana. Sawa sawa. So this lady kept on forgetting the name of my friend. And my friend was not taking it kindly. And I just tried to say, imagine she still asked me, it might be your name. It can be very offending. But thank God, Jesus introduced this lady. She's a relative of the father of faith. This morning, you are a son of Abraham. You are a daughter of Abraham. And that's why I wanted us to sing that song, that his blood flows within you. Let me tell you, the devil knows who you are. The devil knows who you are. That's why he fights your identity. He would want you to forget. And you have to keep on reminding yourself, I am a daughter of Abraham. I am a daughter of God. I am a son of God. I am no longer a slave to sin. I have been born again. I love that song. It is a personal testimony. And I pray that somebody can sing that song and own it and say, this is my testimony. I have been chosen. I am a son of God. I am a daughter of Abraham. And I am glad this lady was not known. But when it came for time for Jesus to introduce her, she said, this dear woman. And the Lord this morning is saying, this dear daughter of mine, a daughter of Abraham, I gave my life for her. She is so precious. Let me tell you, the devil would love you to remain bound for the rest of your life. Yet Jesus paid the price. And it is like whenever you go to the cross and you are set free, if you don't watch out your mouth, if you don't watch out your behavior, You don't have to bend. You don't have to bend up. You don't have to allow the enemy to take advantage of you. The Bible says very clearly it was an evil spirit. This morning, the devil likes it when you get used to your challenges. You can defy the challenges. And the word of God, you need to know. The promises of God should become your premise. On the basis of this, I mean I am free. Because the devil is not amused when you have been set free. He would want you to remain bound. He would want to frustrate you until you are back to his kingdom and dance to his music. But we have said no, because we know who you are. Do you know who you are? You are a son of God. His blood flows through your veins. You don't have to bend double. You don't have to empower other people to name you. You need to know your name. And every morning you wake up, remind yourself, this is my name. I am a son of God. My prayer is this, that you will desire to be at the right place. You will desire to do the right thing. You will desire, because when you are in the right place, the blessings of God locate to you. Could that be that you have missed out on his blessings because you are in the wrong place? How I pray that the Lord will sharpen your spirit, your antenna, that you will hear the voice telling you, this is the way, walk in. Because when you do that, it will no longer be your business. He will take over your battles. In the case of this lady, the ladies had no voice. But let me tell you, Jesus took over the battle. When Jesus took it up, verse 17, where we end at. When Jesus took it up, this shamed his enemies. But all the people rejoiced at the wonderful things he said. I pray that the Lord will take over your battles. Let God arise and your enemies be scattered and your enemies be ashamed, because you are no longer a slave of the enemy. Do not empower the devil, because you are a son of God. We'll do that song one more time. And I want you to sing with the understanding. I don't know what it is that you came to the house of God this morning and you are bent over. It is weighing you down. If you are to see your spirit, maybe some of us look like they have a hump. It is okay, because you are in the right place. The Lord will take over your battles. You know the concerns you have this morning. You know what is weighing you down. You know that one. You know it. And that's why I want us to sing that chorus one more time. As your testimony that he has chosen you and he's willing to fight your battles. Can we rise? Sing with understanding. Even if you are not the type, you know, some of us, by the grace of God, by the way, we are different. Some of us, since you know, you don't want to open, I'm not condemning anybody. But I pray, you may not look like your volume is so high, but I pray the volume of your spirit will be so high that you are reaching out to God, who wants to take over your battle. Amen.
You are loving me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemy. Till all my fears are gone, you are
want me to include you in this prayer. I want you to lift up your hand. There is that body that has defied you, and you want the power of God as we connect this morning to melt that bondage, because you are no longer a slave to sin. You are a daughter of Abraham, a son of Abraham. Father, this morning by faith, we lift up our hands and our hearts to you, connecting with the divine, that which has defied, that has crippled us, that has made us immobile. This morning, may every bondage melt in your presence, because God, you are here in our midst. Lord, would you reach out to my brother, to my sister this morning. We bless your name, Lord. We receive by faith this morning. We receive your touch this morning by faith in Jesus' name.
Audio Jungle.